there may still be a great future in plastics. Cirplus and a handful of other organizations are working to create a circular economy for plastics. These pioneers leverage digitalization to return a higher value to waste and drive the large-scale collection, recovery, and recycling of valuable hydrocarbons. It's a modern approach that removes dependence on crude oil and puts focus on the value of raw materials already at our disposal.
Plastics actually has a great value, and we should understand that. And having single-use products creates this idea that they're not worth anything, but they are. To have the understanding of the value of plastics, that's the starting point for everything.
The future of plastics depends on two important changes. The systemic change that everything that we produce, convert and recycle is in a carbon neutral circular economy. And secondly, that we digitalize the entire value chain from production, converting and trading and also recycling. We need to track everything and control this in a digital manner.
More than 90% of all plastics produced every year go to waste. Digitalization unlocks a paradigm shift throughout the industry and opens a pathway to closed loop recycling. Harnessing the power of artificial intelligence to process data on every material within the system enables efficiencies throughout the life cycle of plastics, from design to converting to recycling, over and over again.
We have to reach higher sorting quotas, and digitalization is very important to increase the throughput and to increase the recovery and the purity of the material that we are sorting to bring this material back into circularity.
Even more important is that digitalization will be a key enabler for a circular economy. The transparency on what material is available where in the value chain and at what qualities and what quantities that allows us to establish a circular economy for plastics.
Humans are unable to process the vast complexity of plastic materials produced. Digitalization advances the entire process to particle data and confirms the purity and structure of materials converted into recyclates. The transparency and traceability of material streams on a shared network unlock new markets for these recyclates in a global marketplace.
When it comes to digitalization, we need all the data that are available. We can compare the products, we can compare the recycled material with virgin material.
If we want to have a real circular economy, we have to learn more. And the learning curve is quicker if we have standards. And this is one thing we've done via a standard within DIN to get a standardized idea what kind of information each and every company in the whole process change will need to get the work done based on data.
We have to find a common understanding in the whole industry, because plastic is everywhere in the world and we have production everywhere in the world, and we know common standards are quite difficult. But otherwise, if we are not on this level of communication and understanding, it will be hard to have a really good circular economy.
Over 8 billion tons of plastic have been produced. Microplastics exist in the air, water, soil, and human body. A global agreement towards digitalization is a critical step towards bringing this material back into circularity and out of the environment. With today's technology, closing the loop is a reality only restrained by human will.
The most important driver for circularity in the plastic would be to have a clear legislation how much percentage of recycled material has to be in the end product. That would drive the demand, that would drive the collection, that would drive the business and the industrialization.
Digitization is core to closing the loop on plastics for good, because if you really look at the complexity of what it means to bring waste from household levels back to products at global supply chain level, then that is a task that is too much for any human brain. And the composition of it is changing every day. It's so complex that no human brain in the world can do that in a way if we're really serious about building global, reliable supply chains for recycled plastics. That is why Cirplus is designed to become a neural network for the circular plastic economy, taking that impossible task out of the human's hand and into the hands of artificial intelligence, and thus closing the loop for plastics.